Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. In this video I'm going to talk about arrays in Codesys. What is an array and how to declare and use this type of variable in your Codesys program? What's an array? Consider a situation where we need to store 5 integer numbers. If we use programming simple variable and data type concepts, then we need 5 variables of integer data type, and the program will be as follows. It was simple because we had to store just 5 integer numbers. Now let's assume we have to store 100 integer numbers. Are we going to use 100 variables? To handle such situations, almost all programming languages provide a concept called an array. An array is a collection of items of the same data type stored at a memory location. This grouping data of the same type in the same container makes it easier to manage, access, and modify it. Instead of declaring individual variables, we just declare one array variable of integer type. Here 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4 are indexes associated with our variables, and they are being used to represent individual elements available in the array. Now let's declare an array in Codesys. Write a name for your variable. We want to declare an array of integer. Colon and then write array. Now we need to define the dimension of our array. We have 5 integer numbers, so we need to define it from 0 to 4 or 1 to 5. So open a square bracket and write 0, 2 points and 4 and close it. Now we have declared our array with 5 elements, but we need to define what kind of variables these elements are inside the array variable. As I said, we need to declare an array of integers, so I'm going to write here int and semicolon. That's it. Now we have an array with 5 elements, which are integer. We can access the array in our program using the index of the element. For example, we want to change the first element of the array inside our program to 10. So we have the array name and then the index and then the assignment. I'm going to declare a Boolean variable. When this variable is true, then the array value will be changed. Let's run the simulation. As you see, the start variable is still false, so all the elements have the initial value of 0. I'm going to change the start to true. As soon as the start is true, the first element is changed to 10. That was a simple example of how to declare and use an array in Codesys. Now let's talk about initialization of an array. Here all the elements have an initial value when I run the program. But sometimes we want to initialize an array at declaration such that the array has some default values. For example, we want the first element to be 5 and the third one 8 when I start the program. This can be done in the following way. Delete the semicolon and use the assignment sign. Square bracket and write the value of each element. At the end, close the bracket and semicolon. Once again, if we don't modify the values of the elements here, they will be initialized with 0. Log in and download the change. Now the elements are initialized with the defined values. The next point is that we can declare an array with more than one dimension. Let's declare another array, this time with the auto declaration. I'm going to declare an array of real, write a name, click here and select array wizard. For the first dimension, let's define it from 0 to 1 with 2 elements, and the second dimension with 3 elements. Type of the elements will be real. Hit OK. Here we can also initialize our elements. The first index refers to the first dimension and the second one is for second dimension. Write your desired values. If you want, you can write a comment for this variable. Our array of real with two dimensions will be declared. Access to the array is like always, just we need to specify two indexes. Run the simulation. I'm going to change the start to true. The elements with the index 0 and 1 is changed to 20. Alternative syntax for multidimensional arrays, we can also use array of arrays. It means we can declare the second array in this way. The first array is another array of the second array. And also we need to separate the values with brackets. Download the change. Both of the arrays are the same, but the indexes are shown differently. Alright, as you can see, we have declared different arrays and initialized each element of the arrays with the desired value. This is a good approach, but the problem is that if we have an array of 100 elements and we want to initialize all the elements to the value 2, are we going to write 100 times 2 here? Let's declare another array with 100 elements. All we have to do is to specify how many elements of the array we want to initialize and then write the value just like this. So here we have initialized all the 100 elements with the value 2. Or let's initialize the first 10 elements with 3 and then 20 elements with 5 and the rest with 2. The first 10 elements are now 3, 20 elements are 5, and the rest are 2. In this way, we can initialize large arrays. The last point about arrays is that we can use different kinds of data types for an array. For example, we can even declare an array of function blocks. Let's create a function block. Declare an integer variable. and create a simple program that with each program cycle, the value will be incremented by one. Go to the main program and declare an array of functions. Write the name of the function block. In the program, I'm going to have access to the indexes 2 and 3. We have 5 function blocks in an array. If I activate the start, the function with index 2 will be activated. Otherwise, the function index 3 will run. Let's simulate the program. The start is false, so the third function is active. When the start is true, second function of the array will be activated. Alright, that was another tutorial on Codesys programming about arrays. Arrays are among the oldest and most important data structures and are used by almost every program. I hope this tutorial was helpful to you to learn arrays. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. See you next video. Bye!